Hi, I'm Jeff Bretschall with Redneck Restorations. This old truck brought to you by ElderlyIron.com. Well, I don't have an engine crane, and I don't have a crane for lifting cabs off of truck frames, but what I do have is junk. So what I have is this old boom made from a 1930s Dodge truck axle that I picked up in a scrap haul. And when it sits back, if the wheels are here, it sits back in an angle, there's not enough room, the roof of the cab wants to hit here. The backhoe, this is July 2016, the backhoe is still broke, and it doesn't have enough room. You saw in the other video where I got to use the hoe part of it, but then you got to put weight in the bucket, and if you just barely touch the lever and it swings. So I need something that the cab won't swing, that I can pick it up off the frame and take it out back in the woods somewhere that's portable, and that's what this is going to do. So how I'm going to go about that is that's the end that the boom's got to go on, but I need to extend it out 4 foot horizontally. And this used to be a trailer hitch. Those are 7 foot long pair of C-channels. I don't think I need both of them. I really don't, not for the weight this is ever going to hold, but that's kind of a different looking hitch. That'll go away somewhere. Anyway, I tore that up all apart already. I decided I would just grab the camera and go look. For those of you who have ever seen my 78 GMC dump truck, this apparatus is an overhead crane. The rollers rest on top of the rail. And on those brackets there, there's a pair of wheels that go underneath the rail and hook on it. And then I made this, that old skill saw toolbox, mounted it upside down, put my electric winch in there. And that's what I used to use for when I used to haul scrap. I used to pick up engines and heavy stuff to put in the back of the dump truck, because you could pick it up to the top, and then you could roll that all the way to the front of the bed and set it back down. So that's coming off of there. I'm going to take this bar, the whole mounting bar, because I'm going to leave that box, and that's going to get mounted on the boom, and I'm going to take that wheel because I need that too. Okay, pulley, not wheel. A pulley is a wheel, but a wheel is not necessarily a pulley. Timing affects dwell. No, dwell affects timing, but timing does not affect dwell. Got it? You may notice this little swale here. That's because I had the bucket underneath it with the tractor carrying this around, and I had a chain hanging off up here, and the chain went underneath the front tire of the tractor, which grabbed hold of the bottom of this thing and pulled it down, which made all that go boop. So, and I ain't even gonna fix it. I'm just gonna drive this pin back in. And now I've got to get this laid over on its side so I can work on that. Well, I thought I hit the record button, but I didn't hit the record button, so you didn't get to see me flop this thing over on its side and then stand it back up so I could have it on this plane that I need it on. So, oh well. This is YouTube. Okay, so we eyeball that angle right there. That's about straight. Yeah, let's see. That's about straight with that. I like that. And we come up here and we come off of that. So that means that that piece of channel has to come across that angle. I like that. Where this big bolt is. I'll take that bolt out. I need 4 feet off of here to clear the cab from hitting this. That leaves me 3 foot on these 7 foot long channels sticking out the back over there. And then I'll tie into the back of that down to the boom again. So I'll pop a hole in the channel at probably 4 foot, 4.5 feet, or 4.3, somewhere around there. But in the meantime, I'm going to cut this channel out back to here. You didn't really just do that, did you? Yes, I did. 4 foot. I don't even need 4 foot. I could go 3.5.
I'll go 3.5. And why not make it adjustable? Okay, the way to light a torch is turn your fuel on, light your fuel, add your oxygen. Okay? That's how to do it. You didn't really think I was going to drill this, did you? Look at an 1 5/8. Happens to be the largest wrench I have. Is it gonna do it? Place your bets. Did you win? I won the bet. I didn't win getting it off there though. Don't ever, ever let me catch you like a torch like that. I like to get them glowing like that because I don't like to heat it twice. Let that cool a bit. I just want the best sound like you. I think that's all the heat we need for now. Okay, everything's cooled off. So then, it's kind of interesting how different geometric configurations like this and how the weight is displaced on the jack stands changes with just a little bit of shifting. So when I knock this pin out of here, that's going to be interesting to see what happens to all this. I mean, it looks like it's all supported where it should stay together, and when it comes apart it could be just like this jumbled mess. I might have to go get some help to put back together again. But anyway, these each weigh 50 pounds. It's almost like 50 pounds right on the nose. So when I put these on, I'm gonna have to put 100 pounds of ballast down on the tongue so I still have balance. We'll see if I can knock it off the jack stand. Fireless day. Too bad. Not too bad at all. I wonder if the binding of the threads will force it to unscrew. Why, no, it won't. So these two parts are firmly affixed and welded and bolted. So they shouldn't change. Doesn't mean they won't. They could be under tension. And this swivels on that end. So who knows what will happen. If I push again it, and then I spin it, whether I'll win it. By Jove, Isaac, that's got it. And nothing moved. Now for fun time. Make sure that I have the hole for my pulley pointing downward, and that it's on the inside, which means I need this one. Balance. Observe the angle. No, more torching. Okay, so nip more of that, and nip this. mess up the threads. He strips them by rotating them in a bind. I knew it was too good to be true. Just don't have the right hammer. I guess I just don't know how to use a hammer. Oh, that moved. Eighth.
You're making me very angry.
I could just get that to stay right there. And that pin go down, it would go right through. But now that I've put myself in this position, I don't know where I put my hammer. Oh, there it is. It's somewhere up there. Am I hitting the bolt? No. Still not hitting the bolt. Where's that bolt? I am hitting the bolt. It's like there. I think all it needs is some driving force. Like it! Let's see how bad it binds. Let's start with the end that has not much threads. Right past him. And the thready end. Yep, that's cleaned up. Quite lovely indeed. Now, I gotta struggle this thing up there. I think I will do it with the aid of hydraulic assist. Like it. Lube. Forward. Did you see the way those two ends came together? I don't think I could have planned it better. Like it! That looks pretty eyeball good. That should be parallel with the tongue. You figure I got 36 inches from where the pulley is to the hole. And the center line of the cab is just about there somewhere. Can't really tell from here. 30 inches. That'll do it. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Just adequately torqued it all. Proper tool for the job. Don't want to lose that.
So, rifling through the junk drawer, I come up. There's the original. I got one just a little bit longer. No good. No good. But there's this. This is actually part of a broken, something that's broke. Anyway, so here's another bolt that we can use. Don't like that nut. Here's another one. Use that washer too, and this washer. Wants to go on this end. There it goes. So the other nut will work. How about a lock washer? Lock washer. Take this just in case. How about another lock washer? Doesn't want to go on there. Ah, I just saw it. No. No. It must. Ah. We have a winner. Okay. Back to it.
This is why you never throw anything away. That's why I never throw anything away. You can do what you want. Oh, that's not going to work well. I'm going to have to heat these up. Angle them some more so they match the angle of this. So, I've got my fingering tool. I'm figuring if I come parallel with that pulley and I match the angle, amplitude of this angle here, this channel. Close. I mean, it ain't much. Heat and beat.
So look, my crescent wrench calibrated. Ah, see? See all that sense here? Huh? All from lighting the torch proper. Because see, it's got this here pin. See? So when it grips it, it's got a grip on the pin. If it grips on the washers, not quite cutting. If it grips on the washers, the wheel don't turn. All the hair's still there. Far. Maybe. See what happens when we throw this again out. It'll be hard. A wee bit too far, Captain. More heat. That should put me right in the parking lot. Other than the twist tweak on this, my angulation is correct. Don't touch it. Okay. That's all I can do for tonight. Do I continue on with this, or do I make a part two? You're going to find out in 3, 2. So how do I go about estimating parallelity with the hitch? How about a board? I could measure the angle, I suppose. But in the meantime, whenever lighting your torch, do not turn on your oxygen and then add gas. I need darkness. Ah! Even more, Captain. Done. Next.
Now, where's my wrench? No. Oh.
Okay. Try something else. What? Darkness. Light. Light. Stay. File. Nip and tuck.
You see that itty bitty angle in the middle? That's the one we got to match. With the great big angle of the iron.